Hyperthreading is Intel's proprietary simultaneous multi-threading implementation used to improve parallelization of computations performed on x86 microprocessors. It first appeared in February 2002 on Xeon server processors and in November 2002 on Pentium 4 desktop CPUs. Later, Intel included this technology in Itanium, Atom, and Core i-series CPUs, among others. For each processor core that is physically present, the operating system addresses two virtual or logical cores, and shares the workload between them when possible. The main function of hyperthreading is to decrease the number of dependent instructions on the pipeline. It takes advantage of superscalar architecture. They appear to the OS as two processors, thus the OS can schedule two processes at once. In addition, two or more processes can use the same resources. If resources for one process are not available, then another process can continue if its resources are available. Hyperthreading requires not only that the operating system supports SMT, but also that it be specifically optimized for HTT, and Intel recommends disabling HTT when using operating systems that have not been optimized for this chip feature. Overview. Hyperthreading technology is a form of simultaneous multi-threading technology introduced by Intel. Architecturally, a processor with hyperthreading technology consists of two logical processors per core, each of which has its own processor architectural state. Each logical processor can be individually halted, interrupted, or directed to execute a specified thread, independently from the other logical processor sharing the same physical core. Unlike a traditional dual-core processor configuration that uses two separate physical processors, the logical processors in a hyper-threaded core share the execution resources. These resources include the execution engine, the caches, the system bus interface, and the firmware. These shared resources allow the two logical processors to work with each other more efficiently, and lets one borrow resources from the other when one is stalled. A processor stalls when it is waiting for data it has sent for so it can finish processing the present thread. The degree of benefits seen when using a hyper-threaded or multi-core processor depends on the needs of the software, and how well it and the operating system are written to manage the processor efficiently. Hyper-threading works by duplicating certain sections of the processor A0, those that store the architectural state A0, but not duplicating the main execution resources. This allows a hyper-threading processor to appear as the usual physical processor and an extra logical processor to the host operating system, allowing the operating system to schedule two threads or processes simultaneously and appropriately. When execution resources would not be used by the current task in a processor without hyper-threading, and especially when the processor is stalled, a hyper-threading equipped processor can use those execution resources to execute another scheduled task. This technology is transparent to operating systems and programs. The minimum that is required to take advantage of hyper-threading is symmetric multiprocessing support in the operating system, as the logical processors appear as standard separate processors. It is possible to optimize operating system behavior on multiprocessor hyper-threading capable systems. For example, consider an SMP system with two physical processors that are both hyper-threaded. If the operating system's thread scheduler is unaware of hyper-threading, it will treat all four logical processors the same. If only two threads are eligible to run, it might choose to schedule those threads on the two logical processors that happen to belong to the same physical processor. That processor would become extremely busy while the other would idle, leading to poorer performance than is possible by scheduling the threads onto different physical processors. This problem can be avoided by improving the scheduler to treat logical processes differently from physical processes. In a sense, this is a limited form of the scheduler changes that are required for NUMA systems. History: Denelcore, Incorporated introduced multithreading with the HEP in 1982. The HEP pipeline could not hold multiple instructions that were independent because they belonged to different processes. Only one instruction from a given process was allowed to be present in the pipeline at any point in time. Should an instruction from a given process block in the pipe, instructions from the other processes would continue after the pipeline drained. Intel implemented hyper-threading on an x86 architecture processor in 2002 with the Foster MP-based Xeon. It was also included on the 3.06er GHZ Northwood-based Pentium 4 in the same year, and then remained as a feature in every Pentium 4 HT, Pentium 4 Extreme Edition and Pentium Extreme Edition processor since. Previous generations of Intel's processors based on the Core microarchitecture do not have hyper-threading, because the Core microarchitecture is a descendant of the P6 microarchitecture used in iterations of Pentium since the Pentium Pro through the Pentium 3 and the Celeron and the Pentium 2 Xeon and Pentium 3 Xeon models. Intel released the Nehalem in November 2008 in which hyper-threading made a return. The first generation Nehalem contained 4 cores and effectively scaled 8 threads. Since then, both 2 and 6 core models have been released, scaling 4 and 12 threads respectively. The Intel Atom is an in-order processor with hyper-threading, for low-power mobile PCs and low-price desktop PCs. The Itanium 9300 launched with 8 threads per processor through enhanced hyper-threading technology. Poulsen, the next generation Itanium, is scheduled to have additional hyper-threading enhancements. The Intel Xeon 5500 server chips also utilize two-way hyper-threading. Performance claims: the advantages of hyper-threading are listed as improved support for multi-threaded code, allowing multiple threads to run simultaneously, improved reaction and response time. According to Intel, the first implementation only used 5% more die area than the comparable non-hyper-threaded processor, but the performance was 15-30% better. Intel claims up to a 30% performance improvement compared with an otherwise identical, non-simultaneous multi-threading Pentium 4. Tom's Hardware states in some cases a P4 running at 3.0 GHz with HT on can even beat a P4 running at 3.6 GHz with HT turned off. Intel also claims significant performance improvements with a hyper-threading enabled Pentium 4 processor in some artificial intelligence algorithms. Overall, the performance history of hyper-threading was a mixed one in the beginning. As one commentary on high-performance computing from November 2002 notes, hyper-threading can improve the performance of some MPI applications, but not all. Depending on the cluster configuration and, most importantly, the nature of the application running on the cluster, performance gains can vary or even be negative. The next step is to use performance tools to understand what areas contribute to performance gains and what areas contribute to performance degradation. As noted above, performance improvement seen is very application dependent. However, when running two programs that require full attention of the processor, it can actually seem like one or both of the programs slows down slightly when hyper-threading technology is turned on. This is due to the replay system of the Pentium 4 tying up valuable execution resources, equalizing the processor resources between the two programs, which adds a varying amount of execution time. The Pentium 4 Prescott and the Xeon Nikona processors received a replay queue, which reduces execution time needed for the replay system. This is enough to completely overcome that performance hit. Drawbacks: when the first HT processors were released, many operating systems were not optimized for hyper-threading technology. In 2006, hyper-threading was criticized for energy inefficiency. For example, specialist low-power CPU design company Arm stated simultaneous multi-threading can use up to 46% more power than ordinary dual-core designs. Furthermore, they claimed SMT increases cache thrashing by 42%, whereas dual-core results in a 37% decrease. Intel disputed this claim, stating that hyper-threading is highly efficient because it uses resources that would otherwise be idle. In 2010, Arm said it might include simultaneous multi-threading in its future chips. However, this was rejected in favor of their 2012 64-bit design. In 2013, Intel dropped SMT in favor of out-of-order execution for its Silvermont processor cores, as they found this gave better performance. Security: in May 2005, Colin Percival demonstrated that on the Pentium 4, a malicious thread can use a timing attack to monitor the memory access patterns of another thread with which it shares a cache, allowing the theft of cryptographic information. Potential solutions to this include the processor changing its cache eviction strategy, or the operating system preventing the simultaneous execution, on the same physical core, of threads with different privileges. See also, simultaneous multi-threading, computer multitasking, multi-core processor, barrel processor, references. External links, Intel Euro High-Level Overview of Hyper-Threading, Hyper-Threading on MSDN Magazine, Hyper-Threading Overview from OSDEV Community, Introductory Article from Ars Technica, Hyper-Threading Technology Architecture and Microarchitecture, Technical Description of Hyper-Threading, U.S. Patent Number 4847755, Merriam, Conroe, Woodcress Lewis Hyper-Threading, ZDNET, Hyper-Threading Hurts Server Performance, Say Developers, ARM is no fan of Hyper-Threading, Outlines Problems of SMT Solutions, Replay, Unknown Features of the NetBurst Core.